What's up, everybody? Welcome to some yoga class. Today I'm going to talk about yoga, what it really is. And I promise you, it is just, it's a tone gunk is what it is. And it's not actually proper. You know, you can't actually learn how to make your body have a real energy, you know, that starts from up here and runs all the way down, unless you stink. You know, and you know, there's problems with that, you know, because there's taking a shower, for example. And, you know, just using all the math of what I wanted to make, which, you know, I wanted to do like, you know, poses and, you know, I wanted to do something that, you know, would be more, you know, instead of just looking like I'm smart and just being social, you know, I could actually, you know, gain power and accumulation, you know, and draw some energy. You know, but they don't believe in that when you do yoga, because all it is just like doing push-ups when it's difficult. You know, doing all these poses, you know, I've been to yoga, you know, a lot of times. And, you know, I learned, you know, that a lot of the positions are wrong. One position, you're facing upwards with your hands like this, like you're shooting people, you know. And I think that's not moral. And I think the only reason that you would do that is if you don't know how to use, you know, that energy that doesn't exist. You know, I'm trying to convince myself that it does. You know, because I know there's, you know, something like air pressure, and you know, you can measure things, but you can't if it's yoga or Buddhism, you know, because there's no science involved, you know. So, you know, so it has to be the fact that it's just a way to waste yourself away, and that yoga is actually just toga, you know, because I mean, when you sit there and you try to, you know, level things out. You know, I learned it like peacefully. If I sit here like this with my hands, and then I sit here in front of you, you know, ate that, you know, I gain an accumulation of energy. But if that's all it is, and it's just a social thing, and it's still sensory, and you can go in the bathroom as men's and women's, but the only way you can enjoy that is if you're separated from the one that you're supposed to be in. So that would be the fact, you know, that all that is just looking at the accumulations on our body and just obsessing with this black stuff, because there's no real social way to interpret, you know, what that is. And, you know, I mean, and the positions are ridiculous, you know. And it's nothing cool, and it doesn't have, you can't experiment, you can't play, you can't gain energy, you can't be Super Saiyans, and, you know, figure out how to mess up your power, you know. And I just don't think that's fun. And it's a waste. And, I mean, all it is a waste at that point, you know, a literal waste, you know, like I was saying. You know, and I mean it. I mean, I have a dog position. This doesn't do any good for me. All it does is be so, I mean, this is like, the way I look at everything anyway, you know, it's like, you know, like I have, you know, there's like a shadow here, you know, that gets filled in with something bigger than it. You know, when I open my hands out, you know, to me, I just use feet because that's what we use to walk with. You know, so, you know, in between here, there shouldn't be something that fits perfectly in between there. So there shouldn't be science that has me, you know, having to, you know, have something that fits perfectly in between there, but isn't bigger than what is in there to fit into that and be right, you know. Because, I mean, when you look at silhouettes of something and something's missing, you can't put less of what is there, you know, like, You know, you can't have a small hand that's going inwards like this, like a fat hand. This can't be like fat people's legs, you know. And that's how you can tell that yoga is bogus. You know, and it is. And, you know, I know I can generate energy, but I'm never going to be able to do it if it has to do with actually what the yoga actually is. You know, and I've had plenty of that myself. I mean, I can be by myself and, you know, I can chew on my fingernails. I've always done that. And my fingers, you know. So I have plenty of that. That's why when I look at the positions, I'm like, this is just for people that clip their, like, fingernails and clip their toenails, you know, using toenail clippers. And they're afraid to chew their fingernails and clean them. You know, or afraid to just do it themselves, you know. And socially, I mean, that separates, you know, yoga from using, you know, your energy. You know, which, I mean, I am doing bad on because I still have to think about yoga. I think that yoga is actually going to do something. It doesn't do anything. You know, it doesn't do one thing. And it's really a war move from China. You know, kind of at the same, like at a different time it would be. You know, probably at the simultaneous, you know, simultaneous now, you know, exact same time. You know, I would say that yoga is actually, you know, just a kind of like one of those wisdom, you know, I caught you, you know, but, you know, I mean, it's just redundant. And, you know, the language is foreign, and they're using a language that doesn't exist when they explain this stuff, because you can't debate about it, you know, you can't scholastically debate about it, you know, and you can't add things to it, you know. So it's just at that, you know, real low level of, you know, all that is just that gunk. You know, it really has nothing to do with anything. When you do the positions, you know, you can't improvise. You know, you can't come out with like, you know, it has nothing to do with that now. It doesn't have anything to do with power. It just has to do with my hand. You know, just going like, just doing stretches, you know. And it's just so stupid looking, you know. And I feel sorry for it. You know, and I think that it's just a place. You know, I mean, it's just ridiculous. I mean, I could keep going on and on about it, but I mean, if there is a way to do something, I mean, socially, you can't have the word yoga to do what I want to. You know, I mean, to be able to do positions, I mean, I would have to do sexual positions, and it'd have to be in a room with other people so we can at least look at the part where, you know, I went to school, and, you know, I didn't understand, you know, how not to fuck someone in school when I sit next to them and have to deal with that person, you know, or across from them, or behind them, or front of them, you know, and I'm just making them just constantly looking at me, you know, and I know that, you know, because, I mean, I look back at people that look at me one time, you know, and I let them know, you know, that they saw me, you know, so I don't understand why we can't just look at people more like pistons, you know, like in cylinders and engines and cars. You know, it's got that, I mean, you have to have at least one piston that works, you know, in order, because, I mean, it's got to pump, it's got to breathe, and then it's got to take that gasoline and pump it into the cylinder, you know, so I don't understand why our bodies couldn't be pumping into the cylinder to give us energy, you know, because that makes sense, you know, it's, you know, I mean, there's karma, and then there's a car, you know. So I don't understand why I can't just go like this, you know. You know, just practice loosening up what this feels like as a static thing, you know. Because, I mean, I can see somebody going like this all day, you know, and looking like, you know, the Six Flags guy, you know. But, I mean, you know, I mean, there's just so much to the body when it's seen, you know, doing something, you know, hand, you know. I mean, when you cross your legs like this, I mean, that doesn't make any sense. It doesn't make any sense, unless you want to die, because, I mean, insects, you know, cross their arms and legs when they die, you know. And so, I mean, looking at this, I'm just looking at my foot, you know. So, I mean, I'm just sitting here looking at my feet, you know. So why can't we just have yoga where people just look at their foot, and that's it, you know, as a social thing, and that's it, I would probably say, you know, until it doesn't sound gross, you know, it doesn't look nasty and just, ugh, you know, because I mean, this is my body, and this is my, you know, my skin, you know, I don't like it to not have some kind of energy, you know, so, you know, I mean, they should just have something social where, you know, you're just in the middle of something that you're doing, you know, like about to get up, you know, and just feel the sex part of that about to get up, you know, and just kind of repeat it, you know, or do something that you're about to do that normally doesn't look right, you know, and work those joints out is what they need to be teaching instead of just about how this looks when you rub it and then it just makes that, you know, how it cakes up and doesn't be paid attention to? I don't think so. You know, there has to be another name for what we do. You know, probably a whole other theme to go with it, something new to go with it. Can't be Asian. You know, that's what they did with it. You know, it's got to be something that's universal, not something that, you know, is incorrect because I'm speaking in English, you know. You know, and then you can get your eyes off of the perversion and get to the cool shit, you know, which I've been thinking about this whole time, you know, and properly, you know, trying to understand and fully do, you know, but I can't do that. Yeah.